Is this a Bible game?
What?
Is this some sort of, love others and do unto children and orphans or some shit and teach you about Jesus?
No. It's not that kind of parable. It's more of
thank Christ.
Snarky, fucking with your head, existential art game about the meaning of life universe.
Whoa.
Yes.
Art game?
Maybe. I don't know. It's a mod for Half-Life.
Okay.
Let's take a look at the Stanley Parable. All right. So what is the what's the Jason Parable? What is that? Is that you have a cautionary tale for people that can be passed along through the generations?
Yes.
The Jason Parable.
It can be summed up with this.
Uh-huh.
Always check for an Adam's apple.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
That's I think that one goes right up there with Aesop's Fables.
That's the short version.
Serious cautionary tales. All right. Well, welcome everybody to Rage Select. I am Jeff.
I'm Jason.
And it's Indie Friday, and we're taking a look at the Stanley Parable.
What is this shit?
It's a game that came out actually in 2011.
That's not even a real computer.
No. Like it's a box of donuts with a monitor on top. I do like the way, though, that it's going on forever and infinity.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Recursive Indie Friday. No.
It's Dive Kick forever.
Oh, God.
This game, I've heard a lot about this game. Like, the descriptions of it are very arty and fantastic. We're probably going to beat this in the time that we have. So
okay.
I have no idea. I played the demo. The demo, nothing. Like, the demo would tell you literally nothing about what is actually going on here. The end is never.
The Stanley Parable. Never. That's just cryptic. And
is never the end?
Is anyone named Stanley anymore?
Stanley is.
Yeah, that was like 90 years ago.
Oh, yeah. Stanley is a mummy.
This is the story of a man named
All right,
Stanley.
What's going on here?
Okay.
Well, that makes sense. I expected
Stanley
it to be
worked
about
for a company
Frank.
In a big building where he was employee number 4.
This isn't realistic. Nobody has offices
employee
anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
Well,
I was Saturday's cubicle life. What I wouldn't have given for an office.
Yeah, for a door you could close and like whack off at. Oh, okay.
Came to him through a monitor on his desk.
Okay, so he works for like Dr. Doom. He also works in 1984, apparently.
It's like Visioneers, if you've ever seen that.
I keep wanting to watch that, but I didn't.
It's funny and sad.
Yeah.
Others might have considered it. And he needs to learn how to type, because this Hunt and Peck shit's probably the reason he's getting poor reviews.
Yeah. He needs to get himself a fucking, 16x9 monitor is what he needs to get. You're going to watch Netflix with the fucking bars on the top.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened.
What happened?
Something that would forever change
Stanley. What was it?
A pack of wolves came into the office.
That's right. Horny lady wolves.
Yeah.
When he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow.
No! My life is a lie!
Call a meeting, or even say hi.
Uh-oh.
Never in I like this voiceover.
Yeah, I think we need a new classification for games called Clever Narrator.
Yes.
Clever Narrator games. Clearly wrong. Wait, there's not even disk drive on that thing.
Yeah, solid. See? Stanley maybe it's like a, just a terminal time. System, like a white box.
Besides, what fucking resolution is that monitor at? It's like at like 200 by 75 or something. Oh, is it me?
Okay. So nobody's come by to say hello or whatever. Do your dumb shit.
Yeah. Wait, no. Enabled.
Raw mouse input.
Yeah.
What is that?
Dirty.
Shove a raw mouse into the drive.
Wait, no. This is still. Why didn't it change? Is this the game?
This is the game.
Wait, no.
It's menu, the game. See if Jeffrey can invert the look on the control schema.
That's not inverted.
It's a really shitty game.
Disabled. Okay, back. Oh, wait, this happened to me in the demo. This is the only game in the history. No? Nope. All right. What the fuck, man?
You can't just deal with it.
Yeah.
This isn't you're going to be doing jumping puzzles or anything. Well, maybe. I don't know.
What's up?
Okay. Stanley. First of all, go to the computer, look up porn, get Stanley fired.
Porno,
this job is no good for him.
Porno.exe. Porno.
Porno.
Okay, what do I got? I got duck.
You can't use a computer at all?
I got the only button that seems to do anything is duck.
I love finding computers in games and then finding the shit that the programmers have hidden on those computers.
Yeah.
That's my favorite.
Do you remember Doom 3? That was the best part of Doom 3 was that whole interface. What did it mean? Isn't it the Rapture?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room.
Man.
Perhaps he had simply missed
God damn it. I knew I should have believed in Jesus and shit.
You know, if it is the Rapture, he should come find your house because we're probably sitting right here.
Yeah, we're still making videos because everybody that watches Rage Select, well, I don't want to judge all of you guys.
You're all going to hell.
You might all be going
You're
to hell.
You're all going to hell.
Oh, a pencil sharpener? Like, seriously, can I get a timestamp? Can I get a calendar on what fucking year this is? This could be 1979 for
Maybe
all
they're all
I know.
Out at the mandatory rally.
Can't open doors.
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office.
We're going into Office 420, Jason.
Stanley was touching every little thing in the office with his testicles.
That's right.
Nobody's here. I'm going to rub my balls on everything.
That's right. This is Linda, you're fucking putting balls right on your... Oh, wait. Hey, I can do something.
What? Oh.
I can open a door. 417.
You know, if not for this, like, whimsical music and the narrator, this could be kind of spooky.
It could be incredibly creepy. Different, like, slightly lower lighting and, like, some Silent Hill music and shit.
Yeah.
Look in there, and there'll be, like, that straight jacket wheel dude from Knock Knock hanging out.
Stanley came to a set of two open doors. He entered the door on his left.
Go to the one on the right.
You're not the boss of me.
You're not the boss here.
You're not the boss of me.
The correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well.
Stanley was like, fuck the voices in my head.
By the employee lounge first. Just to admire it.
Oh, you got one over on me, didn't you, game?
Eventually, I just want the narrator to go, all right, goddammit, just do whatever you want.
Yes, truly a room worth admiring.
This is a really
it
shitty
really
lounge, you guys.
Detour after all, just to spend
I keep
have
a lounge.
I keep expecting the Counter-Strike guys to come walking through at any moment.
Drinking it all in.
Drink? I want a fucking soft drink is what I want.
That was one of my favorite levels.
Well, give me, office?
Yeah.
What do we got here? I love looking at the fake sodas in video games.
Yes.
Cold drinks.
Get Nukem Cola.
Really, really worth it being here.
Oh, don't
room.
Get snarky. Don't get snarky
so
with us.
Utterly captivating that even though all your coworkers
he doesn't know he's
have mysteriously
with.
Vanished.
That's right.
Here you sit looking at like, these chairs and some paintings.
Do you know my name, narrator?
But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Fuck you, narrator.
No, he didn't.
Ah, yes.
Here we go.
Somebody else's office. Balls.
Stanley was so bad
balls.
At following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fine.
Good job, game. All right.
Is everyone, like, waiting and like, are they in the meeting room for our birthday party or something?
That's right. It was the Stanley surprise party, and we've just fucked it all up. All right, what do we got here? Do not jump from this cargo lift while it's in motion. Will cause death. Penalty for jumping off. Okay.
Okay, jump off.
All right.
It's not...
Look,
oh, no,
Stanley,
okay, it's going.
I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot.
Do you want me to jump off? You want me to jump off?
Really, do it. I'm not. Okay.
Whee!
I'm
Stanley!
His eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and has to tell him what to do.
You
Stanley
damn right, bitch!
Damn right.
And plunged to his death.
Stanley answers
Good
no
job, Stanley.
Man, you motherfucker!
Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Thank you.
Well, it's my pleasure, video game. Where are we back to? Oh, my God.
All
we're all the way back at the beginning.
Were gone.
Shit. All right, we got to speed run the Stanley Parable now. No more ball rubbing.
What?
Well, not until we get back to where we were. Should we take the right door this time?
Sure, fine. Take the one on the left.
Came to a set of
no,
two
fuck that. I'm
going
to
want
to
hear...
God damn it, not again. Fuck you, Stanley. I'm trying my best here. I'm only looking out for you, you know.
We all have jobs to do. This one is mine, and you're making it impossible.
Okay, I do kind of want to know what's in this door on the left, though. What is it? Wait, this is the same place, right?
No, this is
and
like
so he detoured through
storage
the maintenance
room.
Maintenance section.
Straight ahead to the opposite door.
Wait, no, I want to go down this
yeah,
elevator.
What does this do?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, see you later, motherfucker.
You know what I bet this game is? I bet it's a giant circle where they're making you think you have a choice, but you don't really have a fucking choice. You're just going
to
do
but
what they say.
That's heavy, Ogre.
Yeah.
He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now in order to get back, he needed to go,
what do you think?
I don't think
it's reverse psychology.
It's, left.
Go left.
I think that... Oh, damn it. There is no way to...
Oh, no. No, it's to the right.
Ah, you fuck... Okay. All right.
All right, good job.
No, no,
oh!
No, no, why would I have
oh,
ever
you
said it was to the
son
right?
of a bitch.
This is like the word... This is a video game equivalent
it's
of keep away.
God, this oh, is like dear, the Truman Show or something.
Let's see. Should we give the narrator a name? Should we call him? What should we call him?
Dick Nose.
Dick Nose.
Yeah.
Right. Richard.
Lord Richard Dick Nose.
Lord Richard of the of Nosington. Story is absolutely, definitely this way. Are you sure? I don't want to. This looks like a.
Are we gonna get run over?
Is this gonna get kidnapped by this van?
Yeah, the van is gonna take us.
Yeah. Well, who knows? The narrator appears to be in control of everything, and there's nobody else in this entire game.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Oh, shit.
What? No. This isn't right at all. You're not.
Oh my God! It's
Cerebro. Spoiler! No, wait. Is it the dude from the Matrix down there? The fucking architect?
Dude, that's telling us where all the mutants in the world are.
Damn, man. Wait, what is that one? Employee fired? The whole story completely unusable.
How about rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense?
We're gonna restart the game from the beginning. And this
time, what? We can't do that.
He said we just ruined the game. Okay. We just ruined the entire game for us. So,
you asshole.
All right, I'm going down the left hallway this time.
He's a dick.
Yeah, fuck you, Richard.
Richard Dick Nose.
Richard Dick Nose. Stanley
decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps I just want to hear him simply missed a memo. Reading through it really quickly. Stanley decided to go to the meeting room, missed a memo, blah, blah, blah.
If they recorded like 15 different versions of his dialogue so he just gets more and more exact. Wait.
Wait, what?
No, yeah, really.
No, I restarted. I swear I definitely restarted the game.
Richard, you need to get your shit together, all right?
Come on, Richard.
Something change. Stanley. Did you anything when we were back in that room with all the monsters?
No. You changed something.
I didn't get a chance to, dude.
Yeah.
I would have.
Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story.
Yeah, exactly.
You wrote it?
Yeah.
Just a minute ago.
This is a really poor story. You need to go back to story writing class where they're like, okay, then. The first act is the introduced.
Hey, Richard, give us some strippers.
Yeah, please. Or like a shotgun.
And strippers and a shotgun.
Strippers with shotguns.
Strippers with shotguns.
Shotguns and strippers.
An insatiable appetite.
That's going to be the name of my retirement home. Retirement community. Okay, where... Richard! Hello, Richard. I'm going... I don't know what to do, Richard. Yeah, I'm... Come on, man.
Richard!
Richard! Oh.
Come on, dick nose.
All right, so how do you do a maze? You just keep turning right, and then you eventually go in a circle or something? Or I'm going to go right and then left.
Jesus.
This is the worst adventure I've ever been on.
Wait a minute, this is the doors.
There definitely was a story here before.
God damn it.
Do we need to restart the game again?
No.
Well, I find it unlikely that we'll ever
progress. Good.
That's true.
Press forward. Again. Which way should I go?
Better than this. Okay, let's give it a shot. Why not?
I like the filthy carpets. Oh, wait, you... All right. Okay, the Stanley Parable.
What could it mean?
Oh, God. Stanley, this guy's an asshole. Meeting room. He had simply missed a he, I think he's like, oh, you want to see who can be a bigger asshole?
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe if we played the game all nice and shit from the beginning, it would have been just like this nice little 10-minute...
Okay, yep. It's worse.
Oh, you...
I might be remembering this
Where did you put the doors, Richard?
God, it's this possible. Is like a the story is fucking Doctor Who episode.
What's this? Is this a monitor or a window?
The other direction... And see if we missed anything.
Which direction? This direction?
Yeah.
Well, here's another open door. Wait, no, that's the one we came through. 417, 421. Is this going to be like a parable about the futility of life or something? Is that what we're doing?
I think it's a parable about the futility of playing indie games.
There you go. Okay, how about... Oh, come on, man. I can see there's an open door over there. I just want to go to it. Wait, there's a door over there. Maybe I can get... I missed it, I bet. Get this way.
Go through somebody else's desk and see if they have any, like, snacks or anything you can steal.
Richard, can we get some snacks in here? Okay.
Where are the donuts?
Yeah, exactly.
Every office like this has stale donuts.
Right. It's Friday, so you guys have bagels and donuts and kolaches, and yeah. I want to eat all of them. Do you like kolaches?
I do. Kolaches are a great excuse to eat hot dogs for breakfast.
Here it comes.
Wait, what are we doing?
No, wait, never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head back the
Wait,
other
where did
way,
we... Son of a bitch. Did you take the steps. Office away, Richard? Come on, man. Where's the punch button?
This is like that Will Ferrell movie.
PSAT, yeah, in here. Wait.
What? That wasn't here.
This is more like Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless Mind.
Yeah.
Whoa, are we going to find the testing chamber, the test facility? No.
Well, I'll be honest. I don't recognize this place at all. Is this the story?
Why are you asking us, man?
Great. We've got some crazy old British dude with Alzheimer's.
The story took place in an office building. Is
Wait, can we go to City 17? I want to pick up a can and throw it away.
Well, do you know what?
I think we're still being
Since
punished for being assholes.
Since what we were supposed to be doing, how about this?
Let's have strippers! Yay! All right, we won! Woo!
So it's easy.
Yeah.
And it really paid off. So,
Good job.
Well, good job to you too, Dick.
Oh no.
This is a shitty game, Dick.
Come on.
I don't feel right about this at all.
This is $10, I think. It's on sale.
Really?
From down from like 14 or something like that.
Square, and this was not one of those situations.
Uh-huh.
Okay. I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time.
Are all the doors gone now?
Yeah, the doors closed behind us. We are restarting.
What? Again?
And here we go. Oh, hey.
All right. I've got a solution. This time, to make sure we don't get lost,
okay.
I've employed the help of the Stanley.
You know,
Parable
I knew which way I was going
line.
Until you took the doors
just
away, all right?
Line.
Wait, this isn't the way you're supposed to go. We're supposed to go this way.
Yeah.
Should we?
Just follow the line.
Okay, I'll go follow the line.
Follow the line or he'll get his fucking knickers in a twist.
Okay, I think the NSA might be watching us play this game. Wait, that's not a room number. 4B7.
What?
It's all like 4-0.
The line knows where the story
4
is.
Question mark 8.
It's over in this direction. Onward, Stanley.
We're going to follow the yellow brick road. Exactly.
Wouldn't wherever we end up be our destination, even if there's no story?
Don't get metaphysical with me, pal, all right?
Is the story of
I play indie games every Friday.
Where'd you go? What?
No, I'm just looking around. I'm just looking
the
around.
Act of moving forward, are we implying a journey
dude,
such that
like,
a
seriously.
Destination is inevitably conjured into being
I played,
via the
whoa.
Very manifestation
I can't,
of the
okay, we need some,
you do some, like, fancy
okay,
parkour shit?
Mirror's Edge or
yeah.
Mark Echo getting up or Ezio or something?
Now we can both agree that the nature of existence is in fact...
I'm not even listening to you anymore, Richard.
One subjective experience
yeah, it's just metaphysical drivel.
Right? Okay.
Wait.
Now, if my experience of your existence...
Richard, you are... He's getting
lost his fucking mind.
You're getting on my last nerves, jerk-off.
Is this office, in fact...
Hey, when you worked in an office, do you ever have that one guy had, like, a whiteboard in his office, and somebody construct. Drew something on it one time, and then it was there for, like, 2 years or whatever?
Back there? Well, I'd like to apologize.
Good, you should.
I'm not sure where I was going with
I don't
all
know
that.
How I'm supposed to follow
you know
that
what?
Up there, but...
I think what we need right now is a bit of music to lighten the mood.
Yeah, do it. Slayer. Oh. No, it's the...
What's happening?
I don't know. I got to turn this down a little bit, though. I'm getting flashbacks, too. I watched the Escape
Searchlight?
From Tomorrow last night.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. I don't know if I want to follow your insane line anymore, asshole. Don't bother. This is going to be shit when I have to edit this, because I'm going to have to make the game so quiet, except I'm going to have to normalize this one part of the game.
Because it gets all blaring.
It's super loud, yeah. Okay.
Monthly ledgers. Balance.
Have we wandered into the movie Brazil?
Oh, that's what I was about to say.
Da, 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 da. Whoa. What's over here? It's more financial records. Employee 432 peer reviews. Wait, this is... We're employee
hey,
432.
Are we 432?
I'm pretty sure that we're 432. I'm bad with numbers, though, so... We're pretty... Okay. Game, you better submit me something pretty cool at the end of this yellow brick road.
Like a dragon.
Go back
yeah.
And look at that fern.
What fern? This one?
That fern?
Stanley, this uh-huh. Fern will be very important later in the story.
I highly
okay.
Doubt
make
it,
sure
narrator.
You study it closely.
He's fucking with us.
I know he is.
You won't
okay.
Want to miss anything.
Okay, it's a fern.
All right.
Garfield's going to eat it later.
Garfield eats ferns?
I believe so. Is that... John kept trying to have ferns, and then Garfield would eat them all the time.
Wait, I don't remember that.
We're back at the office?
Wait.
No.
You fucked the line up.
No. Line, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right? The story? Is any of this
the,
ringing
the,
a
the
bell?
The moral of the Stanley Parable is don't listen to British people. They don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
Precisely.
Yo, oh, my
here
God.
We are.
No, no,
yep.
No, not again. Line, how could you have done this
yep,
to us?
You fucked it up.
After we
you fucked
you.
It up.
After everything we've been
jump.
Through, you... Oh, I can't take this.
Restart.
Hell with.
Yep.
Restart.
Richard! Come on!
All right, I'm not following the Stanley Parable adventure line anymore,
all
Jason.
Right.
You wait. Know what, Stanley? I say forget the adventure line.
Yeah, fuck that line.
We're
that line is a
people,
dickweed.
Right? Why can't we make up our own story?
Yeah, it'll something be about strippers and motorcycles and
this sounds perfectly
water guns full of, like, Ebola.
Start wandering in, well, I don't know. How about this
yeah,
direction?
Let's write our own.
Yeah, fuck it. Once upon a time, there was awesome dudes, and they had a video
yep.
Game show, and it was the most popular thing
now,
on the entire
yes,
internet, and it was just
exciting.
Nothing but
just
cash,
and
boats, and women
path,
for miles.
Well, it could be anything.
It was awesome.
I think that sounds like a good plan. Be.
Yeah.
I like it.
I'm going to option the rights
use
to Paramount.
Imagination.
Also,
come on, dude.
Stanley,
I feel like
I'm
playing Friday
I'm
the 13th here.
Cocaine delivery whore.
That's right.
Yeah. He brought whiskey and delicious white powder.
Every 2 days, Scarlett Johansson showed up with the weekly Stanley. Cocaine shipment.
Veto the line from having any role.
God damn it,
awesome
line.
Story. No lines or monitor rooms.
How do you feel about games like this, Jason? They're all like clever and shit. You think there's an over too much cleverness at some point? All right, fuck you, line.
You know, I don't know. I think it's kind of interesting.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see. We'll see where it better go somewhere, you know?
We get to all right.
We finally got rested the two doors back from this fucking game.
How important, we mustn't squander the opportunity.
We're just going to stay here.
Yeah. I'm just going to play with the files in these cabinets.
Just walk in circles for a minute.
Oh.
Okay.
How did you do that?
So I know that each door has to lead.
I want to be the lord of a really dull video game. I want this guy to be the narrator for Bulletstorm. Oh, but then there couldn't be any character dialogue.
Means that our destination corresponds with that.
Does one of these doors always tell the truth and one of them always lie?
So starting from the right, let us ask, will taking the right door lead us to where we're going?
No.
And since the answer
take
is
fucking
yes,
door. I don't know.
Yes, by all accounts,
the door on the right is the correct.
That logic is faulty.
Another victory for logic. Come, Stanley. Our destiny awaits.
Great.
Eat me, Richard. Oh, come on. Open the other door. I want to go in this door. All right. Well,
don't be a dick, Stanley.
The confusion ending.
Oh, hold up. What's this?
Oh, cool. We found the design doc for the video game.
Confusion ending.
Six restart. Begin
You're
the following. Find an identical replica of
That's
the office.
What this is.
It's begun to deteriorate.
What? After a long time, Stanley dies?
The narrator is gone.
Eight times?
You've been playing the confusion ending for... Is that 16 minutes? Is that about how long we've been playing this?
So now, according
we're
to
a little
schedule,
bit farther than that.
Well, we started before, so...
Well, we're at like 22 minutes.
Oh, okay.
What if I don't want to forget? My mind goes blank simply because it's written here on this thing.
The wall? I always wanted a wall that had like a giant screen on it. You just put whatever you want to on it.
I know, or at least multiples.
Yeah.
You know?
Is it really...
Multiple walls?
No, multiple screens.
Oh, multiple
just
screens.
Like an Ozymandias type thing.
Or me, I'd
say... But that room probably gets really hot.
Yeah, probably so.
I don't want to be trapped like this. I won't.
I did have an office where I had like four TVs all wired up to show the same thing all the time.
Uh-huh.
That was kind of fun.
Oh, look, both doors go to this room. Wait, what? Timer stopped.
Does that mean?
Oh, shit.
Did we do it? Did we break the cycle?
I feel like I'm in the boring side story of being John Malkovich. Like, fucking John Cusack and them are out there doing their Malkovich thing, and I'm stuck in this room with Dick.
I'm just waiting for Wheatley to show up or
to fall out of the ceiling.
Yeah.
I guess now we just wait. You know, I suppose in some way.
Oh, we're waiting
this
now?
Is a kind of story, wouldn't you agree?
You know, Dick, we've got a show to run here. It would be nice if you could open a door.
We have shit to do.
Maybe
Richard,
like, open this wall or so I could even settle for a restart at this point if you guys just give me a portal gun. I'll make this shit work.
Or any type of gun, really.
What? Okay.
All right.
All of his co-workers were gone.
Is this ending 8 where the narrator dies and we get to die?
How many times have we reloaded?
I don't know, like 4 or 5?
Stanley dies alone. And
oh, the doors are back.
Go to the one on the left. Just do the one on the left.
Okay.
Fuck it. No, do the one on the right.
Yeah. Eat shit, Stanley Parable. You will never be the boss of me.
Fuck you, Lord Richard Dicknose.
Right.
Stop by the employee lounge first.
Okay, we're going to go to the employee lounge.
The lounge was sublime.
Right.
A work of
yep.
art.
Great. Whatever.
Back to business. Stanley took the first open
Okay, wait. We did this, right?
Yeah.
But then we went down there. So let's keep going. Let's keep doing what he says.
To the opposite door
and got back on track. All right.
There it is.
Here's the meeting room. We've been trying to get here for a billion
years.
Hey, tips for not getting fired.
Unbelievably
amazing amount of
work. Hoping he might find an answer
there. Solve a dispute. Let it ball up inside you. Passive aggressive. Resent coworkers for not supporting you more. Yeah, I've worked there too.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. This is pretty accurate. What we got here? Using slides to assure employees that everything is okay. Make sure your slide is a slick blue graphic on the header. Yada, yada, yada. Okay. All right, let's go on.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Broom closet. And we've got a stairwell.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Better be fucking Eric Idle is all I got to say.
better be Eric Idle.
Ooh. Ooh.
Okay. Rich. What if it suddenly turns into amnesia?
Yeah. Rich mahogany. Do you think you could ever live in a house that had, like, wallpaper?
Yeah.
Like this kind of wallpaper?
Yeah, totally.
I've lived in places my entire life with nothing but white walls.
His manager's office, I've seen some cool wallpapers out there. In fact, we're probably going to get some for the house.
Shocked, unraveled, like that. Let's check the whiskey and the smoked cigars that's in his office.
This. Yeah, he's got booze in here. Was being held
from him. Wait, why do I have a crosshair all of a sudden?
Was that the keypad the behind the boss's desk?
The keypad.
Guarded the terrible truth that his
what
boss
keypad?
Had been
where?
From
where's
him.
This keypad?
And so the boss had assigned it an extra
2845. Okay, where's the keypad?
Yeah, where's the pad?
2845.
Open.
But
open.
Of course, Stanley.
Oh, there it is. Okay. Known this. Two. Non-inverted controls. 8-4.
No.
2. I hate having to put in my PIN number every time I want to get gas.
By
it sucks.
Pushing random buttons on the keypad.
No, you told me which ones to.
Input the correct code by sheer luck.
What happened?
Oh, the door opened over there on the left.
Okay. Passageway. I don't know, dude. I think we're getting closer to the spoiler ending again.
To what?
To the spoiler ending.
Where we
go into the room and all the spoiler, things are in there.
That place.
Yeah.
Cerebro.
Yeah, Cerebro. Or I call it the architect room, but.
Okay.
Is that what?
Ipso facto, proviso, blah blah blah.
Yeah,
where that guy starts. Well, that was the architect, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where he was just jabbering.
Yep. Peculiar. Well, he was saying something. I went back and watched that shit and tried to untangle it. It was like needlessly cryptic metaphysics. When you actually listen to what people say and puzzle it out, sometimes the shit that sounds real deep and stuff is just dumb. You're like, yeah, that's dumb.
Overly ornate information.
Yeah. I know a lot of
very, very simple idea. Someone trying to obfuscate their...
Oh, shit. Should we go to the mind control facility or try to escape?
Yeah, mind control facility, yes. All right. You know how bad I want to have the ability to control minds?
I think that this is going to be our mind. Wait, this is the spoiler room! I recognize it. The platform's up there somewhere.
Mm.
Yeah. This is... Oh, wait. What? Okay, there we go. Yeah, this is the mind control room. Or the spoiler room. Hit the button.
There it is.
An enormous room packed with television.
We've been
screens.
In here before.
Yeah.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to
it
himself.
It holds the game starts over. The That's the horrible secret. Yeah, I got the strength to find out. It's called the A button, bitch. Jam on it until you find something.
Jeff's thumb
That's right.
has the strength.
Turn on
now
the cameras.
The monitors jump to life. Their true nature revealed.
They're watching us.
For the number of an employee in the building.
Yep.
Stanley's co-workers.
Let's see what they're doing. Who's pooping?
Yep. Who's pooping?
Nobody's. There's nobody on any of these monitors.
I didn't see any bathrooms, dude.
Stanley, yeah.
One of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom and
freedom nothing. Means, yeah, freedom isn't free, you know.
thank you, Ted Nugent.
Ooh, no, there aren't anybody on any of these screens.
I don't see anyone.
Is it if we zoom out far enough, is it like Yoda's face or something?
It's one of those.
What do they call those things?
I can't remember.
Stereo.
I remember they were like really popular for
this
like 6 months.
Yeah.
Vicinity. It was too horrible to believe.
It's yeah, it's oh my god, we could have bought lunch for everybody for like a year for the amount of money it took to build this room. We could have had one screen with a whole bunch of monitors on it.
Had been manipulated to accept it blindly.
Oh wait, is this cut my hand off, Luke? I'm your father.
No. Yeah, I was just about to say that.
It's
not true.
Oh wait, that's
possible.
Wait,
it's funny.
In someone else's control.
Never.
It was unthinkable, wasn't it?
There was one of the screens that
was
said pirate.
Did it?
Yeah.
Fuck, man. I didn't see anything that looked like pirates. Blind
to the world.
Okay, where are we going? Narrator.
But here was the proof. The heart of the operation.
So,
controls labeled with
my control status offline. Okay, turn that shit on.
Yeah.
Or content. Walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from
this nothing.
I've already worked here before, man. This shit isn't shocking to me.
Switch all of them to horny.
Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another.
We're
going to
blow it up.
Life.
I'd really rather just get those donuts that we were talking about earlier.
The controls once and for
yeah,
if you give me a shotgun, I'd be more than happy to just destroy everything I see in here, but...
He wants you to destroy something.
Yeah.
He wants you to destroy the controls.
I think I gotta turn the power off.
He didn't say hi. You gotta turn the power off?
And mind controls idle, awaiting input.
Set it to horny.
Blue screen.
Set phasers to horny.
All right.
There it is.
It's already off, right? Do we need to turn it on?
I don't know.
Turn it back off? I can't read what's going on up there. Is that a fault? Shit. I used to be able to read those things. I say turn it on. Let's turn it on.
Sure, fine. Do it.
On.
Oh, Stanley. You didn't just activate the control.
Yes, right. Please don't start
after
me over,
you enslaved
Rick.
All these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine.
Yes.
Is that
yeah.
What you wanted?
That's what
yes.
I wanted.
That's yes. Exactly what we wanted.
Stanley, I applaud your effort. I really
okay.
do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine.
Well,
can do.
But I'll settle for mind control.
Yeah, exactly.
Go, turn the controls off, and leave.
You know what, Rick? I don't care what you wanted.
Yeah.
I want to control minds.
Fuck you, Richard.
You don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find
he's going to restart the game.
Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency
what?
Detonation system.
What? Oh, fuck you, dear. God damn it.
Activated without proper DNA identification.
Nuclear. What DNA identification? I didn't see like a blood screen or a handprint or anything around here.
Okay, fine.
Now, this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley?
It's sure, as long as we get to see an explosion.
Shine. Yeah.
You are the star. It's your story now.
So we have to turn it off or desires. Probably start over again.
This is much better
we're
going to
turn it off. How much time we got left over there?
Little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments
we're just about out of time.
Okay, fuck it. We're going to try to beat this bitch. Just shut up, Rick. Let me...
More time to talk about you.
What?
About
I want
to...
I don't think there's any. I don't think there's any getting out of here, Jeff.
Oh, really? Is that it? What's
I
that?
Think that's it.
You'd like to know where your coworkers are.
I don't care.
No, not really.
Except for Brenda in accounting, the one who always wore the low-cut shirt with no bra.
Yeah, the V-necks that
yeah.
were real deep and shit.
Exactly what
yeah.
happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free. Of course,
fuck
that
you,
was
Richard.
In this instance of the story, sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit
you're
there in your
dickhead.
Office forever.
So he's the devil. He's the British devil.
He is.
He's more like the Canadian
other
devil. He's too polite to be the British devil.
Sink into the ground, swallowing
wait, why are we down to?
Side, or I let it burn to
has it been that long?
I don't think it's been that long. Four.
This version
what does that
the
do?
Four button.
Is that some of the Fantastic Four?
I don't know.
Try to make sense of it,
oh, it's added. No, it didn't add anything.
Away from you. It's quite rich.
Blah, you motherfucker!
Yeah.
I don't sure understand. I think
everybody,
this might have to be one that you have to pay like close be attention better. To because goodness, I'm not understanding exactly what this game is trying to tell me.
I'm enjoying this so much.
I don't.
You know what?
I think I am, but I don't know that there's.
I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not?
I stopped the clock.
Precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on
oh God damn
what
it.
Does he want to see us do?
I
God,
don't understand.
This is like I have no mouth and I must scream.
I know.
Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what
yes.
you're supposed to be doing?
It's exactly
right
that.
It is.
I'm not proud. I'll admit that.
Well, see if you can check your Facebook or something on there.
Wait, there's a yellow button.
Running from button to button, screen to screen,
what?
Taking on every little thing in this room.
You're not the boss of me.
You don't know.
Here's two. Press two.
Or maybe this big red button, or this door. Everything, anything,
he's turning into a sadistic little.
I know, man. Just change the music from this exciting shit to like the Halloween theme. Five a.m. So I feel like I've got no time at all to solve this puzzle.
You're in for quite a disappointment.
Okay,
but here's
dude.
A spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along.
Fine.
Okay, that's fine. I know GLaDOS personally. Like, you're not scary, all right? What's going to happen is we're going to blow up. You're going to put us back in the office, and that's the worst punishment that you could possibly think up. Wait, what's down here? Anything down here?
See what's down there.
That's fine.
I wanted to control the world.
Destroyed
some
so you
nothing.
Well,
I don't even understand the point
okay.
of that.
Okay, Richard is a petulant child. You're a petulant
yeah.
child.
You're just a little bitch.
I'm gonna
Richard Dick knows.
Oh, you Stanley, you can't have the power. Blah 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 blah. Okay, you know what? Fuck you, Richard. I'm gonna just stand on this scaffolding and I'm gonna watch the clock count down to
yeah.
zero. Eat my balls, game. Done.
Lick
hands him. Off the controller.
His balls are out and ready for
right.
your consumption.
Took my pants off.
Balls.
Balls. Bye.
There it is.
Okay.
Back at the beginning.
Back at the beginning, I bet. The controller is still vibrating like a motherfucker. Okay, fine. It's starting to get down there. All right. And... what?
Papers everywhere now.
Already, this was uncomfortable. It's turned into papers, please.
And Stanley decided that as soon as he found a new space he felt safe in, that he would never leave it again in his life.
No, that's not what Stanley decided.
That's not what Stanley decided.
Fuck you. I'm Stanley. I am the decider.
Stanley decided to find an axe.
That's right.
In the emergency thing for fires and start just hacking everything up.
How long would it take us to get back to that the big room, right? If we just do the things, if we go directly there, it'll take about 10 seconds.
Yeah, let's just follow the rules, see if
it's off button.
Decided to go up to his boss's office.
I like coming to a staircase. I like the idea that this game is trying to tell you, like, there is no free will. It's like, well, no, this game has no free will. Your metaphysical, ponderous things about life, I don't care about. What was it, 2498, 2598?
No, it was like 2485, wasn't it?
2485. No, 2845?
He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books. Stanley was
there
in such
is.
A rush to get through the story as quickly as possible.
Yeah, well, eat my balls, Richard. You turned psychopath and destroyed us.
Open the goddamn door.
Open the door, Richard.
So he relaxed for
fuck
a few
you.
Moments.
Turn off the new age music.
Really?
Is it Yanni or is it Kenny G? Ooh, is that Chianti?
Hey, it is.
It's even labeled as Chianti. Oops. Yep.
And all right.
Hey, go, 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 go,
fucking music.
Go, 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 go. All right.
God, this guy's spiteful little bastard.
Yeah. He's making us start over and shit, bitch.
Even after he quote unquote nuked everything.
This would be, you know what? This would be the problem with any. With putting you or I into any serious, like, when people ask in, they write into the show sometimes, and they're like, if you could be a main character in any video game, what game would you be? And it's like,
Stanley,
you don't want me to be the main
door.
Character, my man.
Control facility.
It would be like, you know, that mushroom, it really kind of hurt my feet when I jumped on his head. I'm not going to do that
anymore. I never really liked that princess, so...
Right. I got mushroom blood all over my pants and shit.
I do like this throwing fireballs thing.
Yeah, I think we'll just leave with that.
Yeah.
Go, 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 go. come on, come on, come on, come on.
He's just going to be like, there. You see how easy that was?
Yeah, fine. Just go. Which one was the pirate one? Do you remember where it was?
I don't recall, but I'll...
Did you remember which one of these monitors had the word pirate on it?
It was after it wiped already.
Oh, when it was just the numbers?
Yeah, that's when I saw that it said pirate.
Give me the elevator. Give me the elevator. Come on, we're going to beat the Stanley Parable.
Mind control facility.
It's too horrible to believe. What happened here? Oh, God. They're monitoring us. Okay, where is it?
So it was up towards the top. It was one of the ones up towards the very, very top. Yeah.
Pirate. There it is. Yep. Let me out of here. Let's go.
He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it.
No.
Damn it, yeah.
We accepted it.
Yeah, Richard.
It's accepted. Fine.
Yeah.
You win, Richard.
Yeah. For the sake of our viewers, I'm just going to do what you say and finish the game. Because I'm sure that if we'd gone down the escape option instead of going into the mind control facility, it would have killed us somehow or something. It would have been like...
Controls
but there was no escape for Stanley, and he jumped into a thing full of piranhas for no reason.
Right.
Working, all of it monitored and commanded from this
Stanley was hit by a car.
Speedrun. I wonder if you just do all this shit the first time you play the game,
Stanley,
if you ever see any of
that
other stuff.
Machinery would
okay, good.
There it is.
Let's do it. Did I get an S rank? S plus? Is that it? End titles? What am I even looking at here?
This is dark.
Can you turn the lights back on? There's some.
Hello.
And a rising chill of uncertainty.
No, I'm fine, man.
Yeah.
Oh, we brought a jacket today.
I'm not chilled.
Yeah, it's fine. I got a hip flask. I'm warming up.
He had won.
He
had defeated the machine.
Uh-huh.
Because we did what you said.
Yeah.
From someone else's command.
Yeah. Oh, it's so ironic. Thank you, Richard.
Yeah,
thank you.
That's great.
Even as the immense door slowly opened.
You know, you could speed
Stanley
this fucking door up a little bit.
How many puzzles still lay unsolved?
There were no puzzles.
There were no puzzles at all.
How had he been freed
from the machine's grasp. Where does he even work? And where did he park his car?
Yeah.
See, oh
God, what if you left your keys at your desk?
Jesus. If I was Stanley, I'd just be like, you know what? This is fucking stupid. Just we'll do the mind control thing. Just let me drink on Friday. I don't care.
Yeah. Just keg Fridays. Yeah. All right.
I've read
good stuff.
I've read Brave New World, and like, I'm fine with being, you know, if they're like, oh, okay, so you've read Brave New World?
Yeah.
And we had this discussion in class about like, oh my God, it's so dystopian, it's a nightmare. I'm like, are you kidding me? Everyone's high on drugs and happy with their place in society.
Yeah.
This sounds awesome. Is this just a screen? Is it a matte painting? Through the open
door. Well, just did he?
You can put it all the way down. It's not a door. It's a fucking Wile E. Coyote. Stanley felt the cool breeze. I've lost control.
Okay.
I've lost control. There I think that we won the game.
Yay.
I kind of feel like going back and, like, I want a mod for the Stanley Parable that lets me press X to put up a middle finger.
Yes.
You know.
Now, that was very rude. All right. So that's just, yeah, we're over time. We're way
we're
over
time. All right. That's fine. We've, you know.
Any Friday.
Any Friday, everybody.
Hey, check us out on RaceSelect.com.
Uh-huh.
If you like this, hit subscribe. Hit
woo,
like.
Yee-haw.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You can find us on Facebook and on Twitter at RaceSelect and at Captain Murphy. That's
yes,
me.
Indeed.
We have T-shirts and other fun God. Things available Stand on the website.
In fact, today is the last day to get the PSAT yeah shirt at midnight. Our time, the shirt will go off sale, so get it while you still can,
yeah.
folks.
And, yeah, tell your friends, tell your family, watch the classiest video game site on the internet.
So classy.
So goddamn classy. Came
to a set of whitelist is in your ad blocker, and hey, if you're planning on doing some Christmas shopping on Amazon, we'd really appreciate it if you went to Amazon through the links below and did your Christmas shopping through the website. We get a little piece of whatever you buy. So, you know, tis the season and jolliness and, you know, turkeys and Tiny Tim and all that bullshit. Actually, it's not even November yet, so
no,
fuck it. And that's been the Stanley Parable. And I think that the moral of the Stanley Parable is, fuck you, Stanley Parable. I have never in my life wanted to punch a disembodied voice in its disembodied face more than I do right now.
He was a dick.
He was a total dick. He was a troll.
He was totally trolling us.
He was a narrator troll.
He's trolling our reality.
Fuck you, dick.
He didn't make whiskey appear once.
Or any shotguns or strippers.
Yeah.
Seriously, why would you even have the powers of a god and not make at least one stripper appear the entire time?
Yeah, we finished your game. How about, oh, good job. Jolly good. Here is a girl with loose morals and a D cup.
Yep. Fuck you, dick.
Fuck you.